That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. I feel it. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. I feel it. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. I feel it. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. Tonight's the night.
You guys can be seated. All right.
Awesome. My dancers.
That's right. We got some dancers on this side. Come on over here.
Oh, sorry.
How's everybody doing tonight? All right. We ready for a good time? We got a great show for you tonight. My name is Al. This is not my daughter. This is my wife, my lovely wife, Letitia. She gets mistaken for my daughter sometimes. And we're the founders, and we try to kind of keep this whole marriage well thing together. And we're extremely excited and very, very scared tonight, and that you're here and stuff. Scared, why? Because a few days ago, I got a call from our MC host. Because, see, actually, Letitia and I were supposed to be sitting right there enjoying tonight. And our MC host, something kind of happened, and he wasn't going to be able to be here. And at the last minute, we're like, okay, what are we going to do? What are we going to do? So I text my wife and said, what are we going to do? And so she sends me back an emoji, you know, pray. Yes, 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 let's pray. Yeah, we'll do that first. So after we prayed, we said, you know what, is at this point, we're just going to roll with it. So we're going to be your unhost tonight. So hopefully that'll be okay, all right? So... And unfortunately, we don't have a teleprompter to help us, so that's right. So we got some cards to help a little bit. I got cards somewhere.
So this is my administrator, like, Tish, where are your cards? Don't forget your cards. Where are the cards? Do you have your cards? And then he doesn't have his cards.
That's right. Hey, you ever been in a church where they play the Black Eyed Peas? I mean, how about Camarillo Community Church, huh? Let's give a hand to Camarillo Community Church for being our host tonight.
Yes.
And Pastor Jim Moyer. I'll tell you a little bit more about those guys a little bit later. But like I said, we're excited. We're a little scared, but it's all good. It's all good. We're going to have a great time tonight. We got some great comedians lined up. We got some other fun lined up. And it's going to be awesome. How'd you guys like Chris Up Close Magic with Chris Shepherd? Huh? Yeah. You guys like that? Good, good, good. Chris is an awesome guy. He does a lot of stuff in downtown Ventura, and I asked him to come join us tonight and do his thing. And hopefully, obviously, he probably didn't get a chance to get with everybody, but as many of you as he could, you know, he was able to do that. I want to talk to the guys for just a sec, okay? Just the guys, just me and you, just a little bit, okay? I realize that when your wife told you, hey, honey, there's a marriage thingy going on, strike one, right? Strike one. And then she said, it's at church. And then I, strike two. And then she said, you got to wear a good shirt because they're going to have a photo booth. It's like, strike three. Am I really going to go to this thing? But I want to assure you guys, okay? I want to assure you guys. We had some conversations about what we were going to do at Date Night VC. And, you know, I had a lot of guys in the room. We all voted that we did nothing serious. We're not going to make fun of the guys for not being a girl or, you know, a man for not being a woman. This is not one of those marriage kind of thingies. But you guys can sit back and relax and just have a great time because tonight's just all about having fun. So before we do anything else, though, you want to find out kind of who's here, right?
Yes, yes, yes. So... We, I'm a people watcher, so I like to stand out there and I'm watching everybody come in, and you know, it's awesome. That's been our heart's desire, is that when Marriage Well started taking off, we wanted to see every ethnicity, every age group represented. And so it's really awesome to be up here and actually being out there first and to see just, you know, I don't like, let's see, from younger to, I don't like saying older, I like saying more seasoned people. They're seasoned. Yeah. I'm falling into the seasoned part right now, so. But it's, yeah, so we really enjoy that, and so we're going to see, but, you know, we can look around, we can walk in a room, and we see all these people, and we're like, you know, nothing in common. Well, we're going to see how much we do have in common, so let's see. How about, that's why we have our cards.
This is audience participation now,
yes.
Okay?
Okay, you're going to stand up if you had to make arrangements for the kids. So who had to make any arrangements for their kids? Go ahead, stand up.
Okay. All right. Yeah, let's give them a hand. Yeah, some of us that we're kind of already veterans, right?
Yeah, you know, right? We've been there, done that. We feel for you. We had 4 kids, 5 and under. And, you know, thank God, though, they're all grown up. And, you know, one getting ready to head into North Korea. We got one in Indonesia. Daughter and son-in-law in London, and a daughter getting ready to go back to Hawaii to commit for 2 years with YWAM. So, I mean, yeah so we're kind of like...
we don't have to worry about that.
We don't have to worry about that.
We just drove in from Oxnard, yeah. So we're good. Hey, so of the people that were just standing, here's what I'm wondering. Is it how many of you left your kids with older siblings, and it's kind of iffy right now? You're kind of like...
Huh? Anybody doing?
Yeah, I'm feeling for you guys. We remember.
The phone's on vibrate, huh?
Yeah. Those are you guys texting. Is everything okay? Is everything okay?
I told our oldest, you're not the dictator, okay? You're in charge, but you're not the dictator.
You're not alone either.
Okay, and so let's see. All right. Okay, so how about who... changed more than one time to get ready to come here tonight. Come on, ladies.
You got to stand up, be honest.
The guys are going, what?
I just saw a guy right now. I just saw a man go like this to his wife because she didn't want to stand up. Now I'm not going to look over there right now.
Right. How many? Come on, ladies.
Everybody changed one time and just drove over here.
Oh, no, look at I saw that hand go. Yeah. Okay. I'm not even going to tell you how many variations of this happened up until what?
Yep. I don't even watch until the last one we get in the car because that's the last change. So
that's the last outfit.
How about a guy? Is there a guy in here that would be honest enough to say that their wife changed them a couple times before they came?
Come on.
Right. Maybe a wife that said, you ain't wearing your work clothes today, honey. There's a shirt on the bed. Change right now.
Yeah, all he has to do is I walk out and I just go like this. I'll go.
No, she'll say something like, you were going to wear that? No.
No, I wasn't.
All right.
Okay, and all right. Okay, so... now, we're going to get a little personal, right?
We're going to get a little personal.
Okay, so I want to know who managed to get in an argument this week. Come on, raise
we're
those
in
hands.
Church. You got to be honest.
Come on. No, we are like...
I didn't, but I'm going to join in with you guys. No. Okay.
We had the potential of getting into an argument several times this week, okay?
How about this? Keep your hand up if the argument was on the way over here. How about that? Anybody?
Right?
there we go.
Did you tell him to go right? He went left, right? Right? Yeah.
Just so you know, we've been working with married couples for many, many years, okay? And we can tell. So when we're walking in the front, we can tell. So that's okay. How about... I want you to stand up. Hold on one sec here. Mm-hmm. Hold on one sec. Got all these notes. Hold that.
Okay, you can tell.
Remember, we're the unhost.
Yeah, we're the unhost.
There we go. Okay, people write notes for me all the time here. Okay, I want you to stand up. If your name is Nelson and Diane Quintanio, and I'm sure I hacked that last name. I want you to stand. Hey, there they are. Give them a hand.
There we go.
Give them a hand. I want you guys to come on down because you are getting a VIP upgrade right here. Woo-hoo-hoo. Come on down. Give them a hand, everybody. Come on down. Bring them down. We're upgrading your seats. We got the VIP suite right here. We are, you guys, look at that.
Yeah.
So how about that?
Yeah,
you guys,
look,
what do you got? You got what I call foo-foo water, okay? Yeah. I never drink foo-foo water, but that's foo-foo,
foo-foo
water.
And look at, and we even have the nice glasses for you to put it in.
Yep.
Okay, there we go. There you go. I am, now I want you to know, Al is the administrator, and I am the hostess with the mostess. Okay, so I'm all about foo-foo water.
Yeah.
Look, Fiji water, okay? We went all out. Okay, so here, babe.
Oh, all right. Hey, let me tell you why Diane and Nelson are coming up here is that I was surprised that they came because she was just in the hospital last week. Obviously, you can see she's with child, and I love it. You know, they're like, you know, she's got out of the hospital last week. She's with child, and they still came to comedy date night. So we said, hey, we're upgrading their seats. So give them a hand. All right. All right.
These are delicious. Here, have another one, baby.
They're like nothing I've ever had before. Here. Let's throw caution to the wind and eat all we like.
Let's do. Yeah.
What are these?
Mini corn dogs.
And what is this sauce?
Mustard.
All right. How'd you like that? Quick little fun video.
Yeah.
In a little while, hey, we're going to tell you a little bit more about date night, the date night challenge. 4 dates in 4 weeks in the month of August. We are challenging you to do that, and we'll talk more about that in a minute. We're going to bring our first act up here in just a minute. You're going to love them. But first, there's a tradition. A lot of you have been to our stuff before, the Marriage Well stuff. We got to take a big groupie with everybody, or a groupie, a selfie, a group. Oh, it's a groupie. It's a group picture.
A groupie.
Okay. Remember, we're the unhost. Please give us some grace.
Okay.
Let's get closer in here so you can have the light.
Okay, there we go. Right down the aisle so we get everybody. Ready? Here we go.
Everybody smile.
1, 2, 3.
All right. Okay.
So, if you have an Instagram,
yep.
Hashtag date night VC, okay? So I'm asking you all to help me out. Lots of pictures, okay? Lots of pictures. Hashtag date night VC on Instagram. Okay?
All right. Okay, so the unhosts are going to move off to the side here, and we're going to bring up this guy. You're going to enjoy this guy. You're totally going to enjoy this guy. You know, he started as a street performer. I was telling Letitia, I think we might have saw him out at the Promenade out in Santa Monica years ago. He kind of started there doing a lot of stuff out there. He's done all the clubs in Southern California. He's done a lot of magic shows. When I researched him, you know, we've hired over 20 comedians over the last year and a half to come and do shows for Marriage Well. He's the first guy that he's on Yelp. He's a five. This is a 5-star Yelp guy. Okay, how about that? You know, that's a first for us. So I want to introduce right now the great Omar. Give him a big hand.
Oh,
you. Hey, everybody, keep it going for your unhosts, everybody. Come on, let them have it. Ellen, Leticia, wonderful to be here. Thank you very much for having me. How are you guys doing today? Awesome. Thank you so much. It's a real pleasure to be here. I'm sorry I was a little late. I was taking a 7-hour nap in my car. If you guys don't know, I just got here from Indiana Boulevard, right out the 60 in LA, which took a while to get here, okay? So I'll be doing comedy and magic today. Would you guys like to see this? Wonderful. I just want to get the energy up a little bit. I'm going to ask you guys right now to get off your Facebook mess in the middle. It's like 17 of you right now. I go, oh my God, I was catching a Pokemon. I don't want people to know this. So I'm going to be doing comedy and magic. You guys want to see this? Beautiful, beautiful. Please follow the mic and make some noise. I want the energy up, everybody. Okay, we're done. We're done. You guys, I wanted to do it. All right, cool. So I'm going to do comedy and magic, all right? So now about the Yelp reviews, it's pretty cool. Yeah, I got like 29 Yelp reviews, and I wrote them all myself. It took me 3 weeks, but I did it. And that's why I'm here today, people. That's how you do it, okay? That's how you get to Camarillo Community Church, right? So that's not important, though, okay? So a little history about me before I even get started. I love comedy. I love magic. I actually started with the serious magic. I love it. Believe me, I was still living at home when I first saw it. I was 30. That was last week. They just threw me out, all right? So anyway, my dad is awesome. Actually, I love comedy. I love magic, particularly because my father is the comedy guy. You know, no matter what, I always try to take things seriously. I couldn't do it. In fact, I remember watching The First Magician. He was on TV. He fog machine lights, everything, right? And he was producing birds. I thought it was awesome, like a red silk inside a dove. Pulled the dove out, whoosh, produced the dove. I thought it was beautiful. So I was at the park with my dad trying to do that thing with the silk. And he goes, what are you doing? I said, I'm trying to do the bird. Like, with the magic. And he says, you don't need a dove. You don't need a silk for the dove. Here, give me your sandwich. He says, see the sandwich? Throws the sandwich on the floor. Poof, 300 birds from everywhere. I was like, what? And they said, you see? Magic, mijo, magic. That's how you do it. So, I like to do my first trick. I haven't done anything. I've been here 5 minutes. I haven't done a darn thing. Okay, so I'll tell you what. What's your name, sir, with the blue shirt? Bobbing your head up and down? What's that? Randy, nice to meet you, Randy. Is that Randy with an I or with a Y? I just want to know. I know, it's a joke right over your head. Okay, good. Okay, good. That's good. Zoom. Okay, good. Watch it. Now, I don't know you, right? Cool. Don't pretend, okay, but it's real. Okay, good. So I'm tell you what. Everybody say hi, Randy.
Hi.
Randy, say hi, everybody.
Hi, everybody.
Fantastic, right? Randy, your job is very simple. Inside the box, I've got two decks of cards. These are regular cards, not rigged. I got these at Walgreens, okay? So pick a color nice and loud, red or blue?
Red.
Nice and loud.
Red.
Okay, we're gonna use blue. Now watch close, okay, sir? Check it out. Fine, we'll use red, okay? All right, so tell you what. A regular deck of cards, these are, let me just to make sure. What's your name, sir? Looks like you're falling asleep.
Ryan.
Ryan. Very cool. You know, two Benadryl and came to the show and knocked out, all right? Good, so do me a favor. He's going to examine the cards to make sure that they're not rigged, okay? So please check them out. Are they good? Yeah? All right, good. So watch close. All right, you guys, check it out, all right? I'm sorry, Randy. I only got 30 minutes. I got to cut it short, all right? So I got time for that, all right? So tell you what. A regular deck of cards examined by an audience member? No time, right? So look, I'd like to show you the first trick I ever learned. In fact, I think it's the first trick we all learned. This is called balance. Thank you, I'm the only one impressed. No, don't worry, don't clap. It's not worth it, all right? Tell you what, I'm gonna throw the cards in the air, I'm gonna catch, not one card will land on the floor. This is very difficult. Pretty good? No, it's okay. I'm gonna do it again for the people who didn't clap. All right, watch close, all right, check it out. Guess I'm more excited about this than you. Okay, so watch close, right? We're gonna take the cards, throw them in the air, I'm gonna catch them with one hand now to really impress you, okay? Check it out. Please work. Yes. You can come. All right, cool. Very good. Thank you. Thank you. See, they're stuck, so you can do this too. You tape, everything, right? You can impress 1,000 people yourself, right? I told you to use blue, okay? So I'll tell you what, look. Tell you what. We use another red deck that's not stuck together, okay? These are not stuck. That's the floor show. That card fell down on purpose. See, now it's going to float back up to my hand. Watch close. Not today. Never mind, right? So watch close, right? Check it out. A regular deck of cards. Ryan, I'm going to actually hand you the cards. Shuffle the cards as quick as you can. Please examine them to make sure that they are regular cards. I'll give you 10 seconds to shuffle. 10, 9, 2, 1. All right, sir, so thank you so much. I usually do that really fast so it doesn't give you enough time to shuffle. I don't know what to do from here. These were in a particular order, Randy. Brian, right, I'm just... That cuts 10 minutes from my show. Okay, I'll tell you what. I'll do something a little different, right? So now, this magician was on stage. He's on TV. He was producing cards from thin air. I'll show you how that looks first, right? This is exactly what it looked like. He made it disappear, and he made it come back. It's pretty cool. You've probably seen a 3-year-old do it. The idea is you take the card, you make it disappear, you make it come back. Now, I practiced this for 3 straight weeks, telling myself, I want to show my parents this. Now, keep in mind, I said he had a suit, fog machine lights. So I practiced the card trick over and over. 17 paper cuts later, I was ready. So I put my, I didn't have a suit like he did, so I had a quinceañera suit that I rented, a little snug. And I didn't have a fog machine, so I threw a bag of flour into the living room. And I walked in, and I started showing this in front of my parents. I looked at my mom and dad. I said, look, mom, not once, not twice, but 3 times. I was like so impressed. So I asked them, what do you think? They said, what do we think? Mijo, we think you should move. You're blocking the TV. I said, okay, you know what? I really want to impress my parents. So I said to myself, you know what? Maybe if I started doing Vegas style stuff. Look, I started squeezing the cards from inside the pack, and I realized if you squeeze hard enough, they come right out. It actually looks pretty cool. This is like Chris Angel, just the low budget version. Okay, the no budget version. Okay, so tell you what, to really impress you guys, I'm gonna stare at the cards even after Ryan has shuffled them. Okay, done. Now I know the order of the cards. I know you don't believe me, but I'll show you what I mean. Okay, check it out. Jack of diamonds is somewhere in the middle. I'm gonna squeeze a jack of diamonds into the hand. Is that the jack of diamonds? Perfect, I love silence. This is very good. Okay, so watch close, all right? Some of you guys, no. This is not what I came for date night. All right, tell you what, I really impressed you guys. All right, tell you what. 3 of hearts somewhere in the middle. Boom. Like that. Cool. Like that. All right, fine. I'll do it to really impress you. Randy, you and I are going to do this together. Okay, Randy? Think of a card. I'm going to flick it into the air. I'm going to catch it. You're going to name it while it's in midair, and it's going to be the one that I catch. It's going to be in my hand. That's going to be really impressive, right? Perfect, all right? So watch close. Let me just, okay, good. 10 of hearts, all right, good. So tell you what, Randy, I want you to do me a favor. Name any card in this deck. I have 58 cards in here, okay? So just take your time with this, okay, sir? So hold on. Think of it. Don't tell me what it is, all right? Now, before you do this, don't name any sevens because I lost some sevens at another show, all right, dude? So no sevens. And jokers, because there's 2 of them, so it throws everything off, right? It makes it easier for me, all right? So before we do this, no sevens or jokers, okay? Or jacks. Okay, so before, besides that, you can pick anything else you want, okay, Randy? So just so you know, okay? No sevens, jacks, or jokers, or aces, all right? So besides all those, we're good to go. All right, sir? So you're good with me, right, Randy?
I'm all good.
All right, perfect, all right, so. No, hold on, no fives. I'm sorry, no. Fives? You didn't let me finish, bro. Calm. I didn't even flick it in the air, okay? So, perfect. We've eliminated the fives, the jacks, the aces, the kings, and the jokers, and the jacks. And the sevens, okay, sir? So, it doesn't matter what you name, just as long as it's the 2 of hearts. Because that's the only one I know, okay? Okay, fine, I'm just playing. No, really, it doesn't matter what you name, but think of it. Don't tell me what it is yet, but I want you to think of it. I'm going to get inside your mind first and then do it. Are you ready, sir? Think of the card right now. You got it? All right. The one you're thinking of right now, I want you to forget it. It's the wrong card, Randy. So think of another card right now. You got it? You got it. Now you're thinking of a card you never thought you'd be thinking of. It's going to trip you out right now. Okay, sir, watch close, right? Everybody ready? Let's do this. I'm going to throw it in the air. You're going to call it nice and loud so everybody can hear you. 1, 2, go. Okay. If you didn't hear him, he said five of clubs. Yeah, exactly. See, that's why I knew. I caught the first one. But you said queen of clubs. I didn't catch the queen of clubs. Now, it's the queen of clubs. Thank you. Oh, wait. Hold on. No. That wasn't magical. I didn't show it to you. I'm sorry. Hold on. Good. Give me one. Told you to stay in the car. Hold on. Give me. Queen of clubs. Hold on. I got this. Hold on. There it is, sir. Queen of clubs. Good. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Queen of clubs. Thank you. Some of you aren't impressed. I wouldn't be either, okay? I'll tell you what. You know what's crazy? There's always plan B. You go into the pocket, you reach in there and pull out a card that you put in the pocket before you got on stage, and that is, in fact, the one that you named, sir, the Queen of Clubs. Prediction. Thank you. I could do it again, just to make sure that you believe me, okay? There's another Queen of Clubs, okay, sir? Check it out. Another Queen of Clubs. I could do this all night, but I don't want to bore you guys.